short part of the new dynasty, named the Yuan. They are not from Han nationality, they're from Mongolia. I think most of you already know the history of the Yuan dynasty. They actually from very far away from the north, and conquered Han nationality's Song. And then they actually, this is a long shot parts of the history, destroyed Han nationality's culture. Most of the people, they do not have a chance to involve in Keju, this kind of examinations of their positions in the official government. So most of the literacy, poems and all the composers, they do not have the good environment for them to continue their position in the government and educator in the college, something like that, a higher position in the society. So they involve themselves in the active activities like drummers in the cities. There are several famous composers of operas and dramas, like Guan Hanqing. There's a picture of Guan Hanqing. He's a very famous composer in the history. The famous, the masterpiece is the Dou E Yuan. We are going to present this part.
Thank you.
Dou E Yuan. Dou E is the name of the younger. She was born in a pretty poor family. Her father would like to get the exams, to pass the exam in the government, to get an official position. But he doesn't have money. He sold this girl to her family to be Tong Yangxi. It's a kind of pre-married girl in a family, with her husband's family. Unfortunately, the husband died after they get married. And she has to leave with the mother-in-law. One day they went out of the town. They met some very bad guys. They would like to actually rob them and harass them. At this time, another two guys, the father and the son, rescued them. But unfortunately, these two guys, they are not good to meet these. They occupied their family, house, and they live with them. And the mother-in-law had to, have to accept them because they harassed them all the time. And the son would like to get married with Dou E. She doesn't like this guy. They are hooligans, right? But unfortunately, she has no choice. They have to live with this guy to be their servant. In this kind of environment in Yuan Dynasty, this kind of story seems like popular. So that's why in this piece they say, 有日月朝暮旋，有鬼神宰割生死权. It means what? There's a justice in the world, but there's no choice for them to survive in this environment. The later story, like Dou E's mother-in-law got sick, and she boned the soup for the mother-in-law to take care of her. The son of this old guy would like to poison the mother-in-law to kill them. And they plan to get Dou E as his wife. But fortunately, this poison put in the soup was drunk by his father, his own father, and the father died. So he asked the officer in the government, the justice, put them in the court. And then the justice say, this is the obvious thing. Even they do not have the proof, they put Dou E, sentenced her to die. That's why she was put in the court, say she killed the father-in-law. Actually, it's not true. That's why Dou E crying about this kind of unfair justice. And she say, the people, the good people, they cannot survive in the environment because they live in a poor, very poor situation, and they cannot live longer. 为善的受贫穷更命的。赵恶的, it means this guy is a very bad guy. They can be rich in this bad situation, bad environment, and they can live longer. It's unfair, but this kind of true situation in that period of time. So the last parts, she's screaming out. She claimed the earth and the heaven in the sky. Why you do this wrong? Right? Oh, Earth, how could you be Earth? Because you are unfair, right? This part, she's very angry from inside, very angry. So, but she cannot change. She cannot change the bad situation for herself. Even after she died, she cannot do anything. Just give oath, say, if I die, my blood to fly up to the white silk scarf. If I die, I will say, you will have punishment for you guys. You give me unfair justice. There's no choice. So the last sentence you say, "Ai, 只落得两眼泪绵绵." The only one thing I can do, I cry. I'm crying. So this is a very sad situation for me. After Yuan Dynasty, we call it the darkest period time in our history, especially for the Persian. It only lasts about 8 years. So we see the Ming Dynasty in Ming Dynasty. Ming Dynasty lasts about 200 years ago, 400 years ago. About 200 years history of Ming Dynasty. Kunqi is formed from Yuan Zhaju. The drummers and the music from south and north. We will find a lot of pieces of music in Kunqi. The heritage, the northern parts, drummers, we call it Qi Pai, the music. And some of them from Nanqi. Nanqi is from southern part. They start from Song Dynasty. And they form Kunqi. Those parts we call it Qi Pai. We read this Qi Pai and we know where they come from. And we will know the music. This is the only proof we know the music from the period time before Ming Dynasty. Kunqi, they have a lot of, actually it's opera. They have a lot of performance skills. Now we are going to perform a famous masterpiece, Mudan Ting, from Tang Xianzu. Those names, if you have interest, you can check from the website. Click in and you will see their performance, the videos. Today we choose Tang Xianzu, Mudan Ting. It's from Linchuan Simon, the Four Dreams of Linchuan series. It's the masterpiece in Ming Dynasty. Story about a young girl living in a rich family. His father is the officer who was actually an officer in the government. He has a very strict rules in the family. At that period of time, the girls, they are not supposed to go outside to see the strangers. They were forbidden to be at home, only doing sewing, reading, most of the time they do not have to stay at home until they get married. So we start this piece. This story is pretty romantic. The first, she met a young boy in the garden, in the dream, and they get married they get together very well, and then the dream is gone. She still needs this boy, and she went back to the garden to looking for a dream, and then she couldn't find it. She feels so sad about this. And she comes back to the room, and after a few moments, she got disease. She's sick of missing this boy. And during the time she died, she was buried in the backyard, and she leave a painting in a box, and leave for this boy. In the future, he come back to looking for her. And the boy come. And he found this painting about this painting, very beautiful, and the poem on the painting. And he asked, "Who is this girl? I met her before. I want to see her." And the family, there's another family member in the garden told him, "You know what? She died from the dream. and he comes back to the backyard to find the tomb, and she revived, and she can meet her again, meet him again. We host many problems. A very romantic song. So this is the lyrics of this. The first sentence describes about the scenery in the backyard. And those things they say, oh, she's happy. She's happy about the scenery, the spring, and the color, everything. But Liang Chen Meiting Mai Ho Tian, even she has so beautiful backyard, she cannot enjoy it in time. She was forbidden to do so at the family. And she saw the scenery like Zhang Fei, Mu Jun, Lin Xia Qu Xuan, Yu Si Feng Pian, Yan Hu Hua Chang. So beautiful. On the border, in the mountain, there's rain, there's yeah, everything. She enjoys it.
This particular story, the Peony Pavilion, is one of the stories that we're going to see. So, if you remember, the reactions to that. Thank you very much for your time. Remember in the last lecture, I talked about Jiang Hui, how he published the first Guqin. He wrote his own lyrics as well as the music part to it. And that was the first book that we have from his own hands.
We have a book probably you can find in your library, which is Jiang Hui. He has 14 pieces of music. If you enjoy those things, we have special notes, but nowadays we can rewrite it in the modern notes, so we can sing after we write the music.
So he was a musician and lyricist at the same time.
Any questions? Pronunciation is very special. You recognize that. Before we use, actually nowadays we use Guqinba, like Mandarin or Cantonese. Cantonese is a pretty old language, like Japanese and the Korean language, probably had influence from Cantonese. But Cantonese is a modern language too. Before about 2,000 years ago, there's Hakka, you know Hakka? It's similar to Qin Dynasty. After Han Dynasty and Tang Dynasty, people's language, we do not exactly know that, but we can get it from in Suzhou, Zhejiang, Hangzhou, they have pretty old dialects. They use the old language, it's a heritage from that period of time. And also in some dialects, in southern Mars, we still can find some dialects that they use the pronunciation from heritage from old period time. I use this because I studied Guanxi. My teacher told me about the pronunciation in Zhongzhou Yu. Zhongzhou Yu is from Henan, Kaifeng. Kaifeng is the capital, the previous capital of Song Dynasty. We call Dongjing, Dongjing Bianliang. At that time, this is the original pronunciation from Guanxi opera. So we heritage the pronunciation of Zhongzhou Yu to sing nowadays Guanxi. Most of the Guanxi opera they use Zhongzhou Yu. Yeah, but in Beijing opera or Beijing Guanxi opera theater, they do not use Zhongzhou Yu. Probably they heritage some from Morrison language. But most of in Jiangsu province Guanxi, we use Zhongzhou Yu. We call it Yiyang Qiang or Zhongzhou Yu, whatever. We combine several dialects together. Yeah. So most of the people, they still recognize all Guanxi is from Suzhou. Suzhou use Suzhou dialect, but only the Bai, about introductions and Nian Bai are from dialects. But the, if you sing with the lyrics, we use Zhongzhou Yu. That's why you can hear from An Xiang, I sing with
it's very wonderful that you know this.
Yeah, yeah. It's very special, different. Yeah. Any questions?
Seems also very different, don't you think? Right? Like when you say, I don't know,
yeah.
on an opera.
If you say,
if you open your wife, you need to have
your,
it,
your
right.
real, real sound like
yeah.
But in Quincy,
she barely opens her mouth.
Also, I would like to introduce another instrument, Xiao.
Yes, we do get to play that.
Yeah. We play Xiao with Qin. Qin is lower, Chong is lower. We call this like Wen Ren Qin.
It's
a variety of instrument. Xiao is a Wen Ren Xiao. We make a Wen Ren.
Professor Lin is also the expert of
Xiao. Professor Lin actually is very one of the very few Xiao experts in China. Yeah, he edited several books, actually the textbooks for Xiao practicing.
Can you play some piece for us just so that we can hear it?
Sure. Would you like it for yourself?